greetings. I got a question quite a while ago, and thanks, Google, I just came across it again. If you believe Jesus is the Son of God, just because he was born of a virgin mother, Mary, that means he is a Son of God? The answer is no. Want to know a reason why? Well, what about the first man on earth, Prophet Adam? He had no father, like Jesus, peace be upon him, but also no mother. So wouldn't he be a greater God, Son of God? Every Abrahamic religion claims Prophet Adam, peace be upon him, is a prophet, which is true. Even the Bible. So why do you call Jesus, peace be upon him, God, if Adam had no mother, father? That's quite a mouthful to answer, so let me address this post one point at a time. If you believe Jesus is the Son of God, just because he was born of a virgin mother, Mary, that means he is a Son of God, the answer is no. First, let us consider the logic of this straw man. Jesus was born of a virgin. That means no man fertilized Mary's egg. So if no man plowed Mary as his tilth, a Muslim can only think Christians imagine God plowed Mary as his tilth. That seems crass, but it is the only way someone in Islam can think about it. In fact, Muhammad began the thought process when he argued against Mary, the mother of God, in the Trinity. Surah 573. They do blaspheme who say Allah is one of three in a Trinity, for there is no God except one Allah. If they desist not from their word of blasphemy, verily a grievous penalty will befall the blasphemers among them. Why turn they not to Allah and seek his forgiveness? For Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. Christ, the son of Mary, was no more than a messenger. Many were the messengers that passed away before him. His mother was a woman of truth. They had both to eat their daily food. See how Allah does make his signs clear to them, yet see in what ways they are deluded away from the truth. We see here Muhammad's best logic against Jesus and Mary in a Trinity. They both had to eat daily food. The author of the Quran thought the Trinity was God the Father, God the Son, and Mary, God the Mother. That is simply wrong. If you believe Jesus is the Son of God just because he was born of a virgin mother, that means he is a Son of God, the answer is no. Christians do not believe Jesus was the Son of God because he was born of a virgin. We believe because of the message of the prophets. Isaiah 9:6, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace." Psalm 2:7, "I will declare the decree the Lord has said unto me, You are my son, today I have begotten you." Luke 1:32, "He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David." So we believe God has a son because of the message of the prophets. We also believe because Jesus said, "I am the Son of God." John 10:36, "Say you of him whom the Father sanctified and sent into the world, Thou blasphemest because I said I am the Son of God?" The Jews heard Jesus claim Jesus was the Son of God, so they wanted to kill Jesus. John 10:31, "The Jews took up stones again to stone him." Jesus answered them, "Many good works have I showed you from the Father. For which of those works do you stone me?" The Jews answered him, "For a good work we stone thee not, but for blasphemy, and because you, being a man, make yourself God." We believe because Jesus said, "I am the Son of God." We also believe because God called Jesus my son. Matthew 3:17, "And behold, a voice out of the heavens said, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." Matthew 17:5, "While he was still speaking, a bright cloud covered them, and a voice from the cloud said, This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him." Mark 1:11, "And a voice came from heaven, You are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased." We also believe because Satan tried to prove Jesus was not the Son of God. Matthew 4:5, "Then the devil took him into the holy city and had him stand on the pinnacle of the temple." "If you are the Son of God," the devil said, "throw yourself down, for it is written, He will command His angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands, so that you will not strike your foot against a stone." Do not underestimate the power of Satan's testimony for the Son of God. First, Satan's jihad against Jesus being the Son of God. It only makes sense if Satan admits God has a son, has foretold of a son. Second, Satan only needs to wage his jihad if Jesus has claimed to be the Son of God. Jesus does not deny the claim, and could have if the claim were false. And later, Jesus does claim to be the Son of God. So the prophets, Jesus, God, and even Satan all testify that Jesus is the Son of God. Back to the original post. Want to know a reason why? Well, what about the first man on earth, Prophet Adam? He had no father, like Jesus, peace be upon him, but also no mother, capitals for emphasis. So wouldn't he be a greater God, Son of God? Every Abrahamic religion claims Prophet Abraham as a prophet, which is true, even the Bible. So why do you call Jesus God if Adam had no mother, father? This is again based on the faulty logic that Jesus is the Son of God simply because Jesus had no father. And a second front of the jihad against Jesus opens with the no mother gambit. If Jesus is the Son of God because he has no father, surely Adam is more God because he also had no mother. And that is simply wrong because it jihads against something no Christian thinks. As I have shown, this is not the argument that convinces Christians Jesus is the Son of God. So you cannot wage jihad against it with the no mother gambit. We believe Jesus was the Son of God and is the Son of God. Well, because Jesus was and is the Son of God foretold by the prophets. And the promise of God is that all who believe on Him, Jesus, the Son of God, will receive eternal life. Brother, it is your choice to believe God and believe Jesus, or believe one man alone who calls both wrong. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.